Hi students, good morning. Today we are going to start with a new topic of integration. So even for all those guys who have joined right now, I'm sure that this particular topic is the most easiest topic in mathematics, and that is integration. But of course, for this you would require to get some base on the word differentiation. Now, before I word the word differentiation, you would say, sir, differentiation is all the way done, so why are you starting it again? I'm not starting differentiation, but the word integration lies in exact opposite of the word differentiation. Differentiation means breaking up of things into smaller constituents. So jab bhi mujhe kabhi kisi cheez ko todne ke bare mein baat karni hogi, I'll be using the word differentiating. Okay? But on the other hand, if I need to join something and make something huge, it is known as integration. And this is obvious from the statement that India is differentiated into various, people of various religions. Differentiating. So I am breaking people into smaller of the part. On the other hand, if I am talking about the word integration, now integration means joining. Say, for example, whenever I am using the word Jammu and Kashmir, so Jammu and Kashmir will always remain an integral part of India. Either way, now it is, but generally I am saying. So with this particular example, let's start the word integration. Now, what actually do you mean by the word integration? Integration, in simple words, joining. So you need to, do the exact opposite of what you are doing in differentiation, and that is the reason why integration is also known as antiderivative. Antiderivative or antiderivative. Derivative means differentiation, that is breaking. Antiderivative means opposite of differentiation, that is integration. So what are we going to use in this part? That is again the formulas, but this time the formulas are not to be learned, because yadi aapko differentiation ke formulas aate hain, to believe me, ye around what 13 questions will be done, I mean today itself, in spite of writing all the formulas. So let's understand it. First, d by dx, that is differentiation. Suppose differentiation of x, it should be equals to 1. Yaad hai? X ka differentiation hamesha 1 aata tha. On the other hand, yadi aapko first formula integration ka banana hoga, then you need to write what? You need to write integration. This is the symbol of integration. Integration of and what? Constant, that is 1 dot dx. Yahan par d by dx denominator mein rehta hai. Yahan par d by dx numerator mein rehta hai. Dx. And it should be equals to what? It should be equals to again x. Okay, so dx is showing that x was the variable, so this would be the operator, while over here dx would be showing x would be the operator. Okay, so dx should be equals to x. Second, d by dx of, what do you think? For the word x to the power n, it should be equals to n x to the power n minus 1. Correct? That is d by dx of x to the power n should be equals to n x to the power n minus 1. On the other hand, second part, that is integration of what? That is x to the power n, it should be equals to x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Of course, there is always going to be a constant plus c. I'll tell you later what do you mean by the word this constant after we have done with the part of formulas. So x to the power n ka formula kitna ho jayega? X to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. In simple words, yadi aapko yaad hoga, jab bhi apan kabhi x square karte the aur d by dx of x square karte the, to kya aata tha apne paas mein? Ye 2 aage aa jayega, x aayega and ek power kam, which is 2 minus 1 is 1. On the other hand, if I am going to do integration, so it has to be what? It has to be ek power upar add kar dena. So it is going to be 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1, that is x cube upon 3. So it's going to be technically one and the same part, kind of. Okay. Now let's move ahead. So moving on to the formula number 3. that is d by dx of what? D by dx of log x, it should be equals to, that is 1 upon x. On the other hand, the formula for the integration will be, that is 1 upon x dx. I forgot to mention dx over here. So 1 upon x dx, this dx is going to tell you that this is the variable. So 1 upon x dx should be equals to log x plus c. What is the c? Any constant. Point number 4 or formula number 4. D by dx of, what do you think now? D by dx of e to the power x should be equals to e to the power x, while in formula number 4, integration of e to the power x dx should be equals to, once again the same, e to the power x plus c. So यदि आप ढंग से देखोगे, जो यहाँ पर क्वेश्चन का आंसर आया था, वो ही आपका इंटीग्रेशन में क्वेश्चन बन जाता है, और जब आप इसको सॉल्व करोगे, तो exactly the question of what differentiation. Now this simply gives you a kind of, you know, hint of mathematics. आपने डिफरेंसिएशन को यदि आप सॉल्व करोगे एंड जो भी आंसर आएगा आपका, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द आंसर ऑफ डिफरेंसिएशन. बट इंटीग्रेशन, दैट आंसर वुड बिकम द क्वेश्चन एंड द क्वेश्चन वुड बिकम व्हाट? द आंसर. सो एक्चुअली में यदि आपकी प्रैक्टिस डिफरेंसिएशन पे है, यदि है तो बहुत अच्छी बात है, नहीं है देन गो बैक टू माई ओल्डर वीडियोज और गो बैक टू एनी ऑफ द टीचर्स वीडियोज ऑफ डिफरेंसिएशन. See it from over there and I'm sure that you would be able to learn it. Now, fifth, d by dx of, let's move on to the word sin x. So that was cos x. This time, fifth, integration of cos x dx should be equals to sin x plus c. Next is d by dx of sin x की जगह पर इस बार लेते हैं cos x और उसका डिफरेंसिएशन होता था minus sin x. इस बार यदि मैं minus sin x का इंटीग्रेशन करूंगा या sin x dx का इंटीग्रेशन करूंगा, सो इट इज गोइंग टू बी minus cos x plus c. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट, दैट इज सेवेंथ फॉर्मूला, विच इज गोइंग टू बी d by dx of tan x should be equals to sec square x. On the other hand, integration of sec square x should dx should be equals to tan x plus c. Then comes 7, then comes 8. d by dx of sin cos 10 हो गया, then comes cosec x. It should be equals to minus cosec x cot x. So while this is going to be integration of minus cosec x dot cot x should be equals to what? Or cosec x cot x should be equals to minus cosec x plus c. Right? Next par aa jaate hain. D by dx of what? That is sec x. Answer was sec x tan x. Correct? Now if I need to find out the integration of sec x tan x, sec x tan x dx, I'm guys sorry once again, I did not apply dx over here. So sec x tan x dx, it should be equals to tan x plus, sorry, sec x plus c. Right? On the other hand, let's now move on to the formula 10, that is d by dx of what? Cosec ho chuka hai, sec ho chuka hai. Let's move on to the word cot x. It should be equals to minus cosec square x. And on the formula number 10th, that is integration of minus cosec square x should dx should be equals to minus cot x plus c. Let's first of all understand the meaning of the word c over here, and then I'm going to tell you some more formulas. So c means constant. While differentiation के अंदर constant की value zero हो जाती है, integration में उसी constant का यदि आपने integration किया तो आगे क्या आएगा, x, which means that integration के अंदर जितने भी constant आते हैं, be it the number 20, 15, 17, minus 4 upon 5, minus 0.005, everything will be over there in constant. Okay, now so we have done now algebra wala part humne dekh liya, log dekh liya, e to the power x dekh liya and all this. Now let's now directly jump onto the part of formulas. Okay, so I would require just this much amount of space to be done. And let's try to understand all of these formulas, okay? Just one of the formula which I forgot to mention, so let's write formula number 11th once again. So it is going to be d by dx of, okay, and that is a to the power x, it should be equals to a to the power x log a, right? Yadi main isi part ka integration lunga, say a to the power x, okay, to yahan par kya ho jayega dx? It should be equals to a to the power x upon log a. Kitna difference hai andar na? Okay, let's now move ahead with the part of the sheet. So let's move on to the question number 1. So x to the power 4 dx, so integration of x to the power 4 dx, it should be equals to which formula are we going to use? X to the power n. Kya formula hota hai? That is x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. Or it should be equals to x to the power 5 upon 5 plus c. And that's all is the answer. Let's move on to now the next. That is integration of root x dx. It should be equals to, अब x की पावर हाफ है तो ये हाफ आगे आ जाएगा. Normally differentiation में आप ऐसे ही करते थे, अब यहां पर आप क्या करोगे, you are going to write it like this, which is going to be x to the power 1 by 2 dx, or it should be equals to, so this is going to be x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 upon 1 by 2 plus 1 plus c, or it should be equals to x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 plus c, or final answer is going to be 2 upon 3, because ye 2 denominator k denominator mein hai, so it will go in the numerator, 2 by 3 x to the power 3 by 2 plus c. So that's all is the answer. Let's move ahead with formula number 3. Formula number 3 is 1 upon or integration of 1 upon root x dx, or it should be equals to integration of 1 upon root x kitna ho jayega, which is x to the power minus 1 by 2 dx, correct? Or it can become x to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 by 2 plus 1, or it should become x to the power 1 by 2 by 1 by 2, or 2 root of x. Why? Because x to the power half means root x. So that's also done. Let's move on to now formula number 4. Or the question number 4, sorry. 1 upon x cube. So integration of 1 upon x cube dx can be written as integration of x to the power minus 3 dx. We'll go at the top. Final answer will be x to the power minus 3 plus 1 upon minus 3 plus 1. Which formula I am using? I am using x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c, or it should be equals to x to the power minus 2 upon minus 2 plus c. That's all. Let's move directly on to question number 5 now. A to the power 3 log ax. So integration of a to the power 3 log ax dx. It should be equals to, can I write it like this? Abhi tak maine integration solve nahi kiya. So what am I doing? I am going to solve this like this. A yahan par aa jayega log a x to the power 3. Kyun? This 3 was ahead of log. N log m is equals to log m to the power n. Logarithm ki property hoti hai. So maine 3 ko aise likh diya. Whenever the base is same and this is same, so this is going to give you the answer as what? Aur yahan par of course dx hai. So this is going to a and a ye log ke sath mein cancel ho jate hain because dono ke base same hai. So it is going to be integration of x cube dx. Because a log a ya e log e ya 7 log 7 hamesha 1 aa jata hai. 1 into x cube is x cube dx. So integration of x cube dx will become x to the power 3 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1. It should be equals to x to the power 4 upon 4 plus c. That's all. Moving on to the next, that is question number 6. 5 log ex. So let's write integration of 5 log, sorry, there was e to the power, it's my fault. So there is e to the power 5 log ex minus e 4 log ex. E is in the base, remember that is showing exponential series, okay? Upon e 3 log ex minus e 2 log ex. Now of course dx is over there. Remember dx will always be over there with the numerator. Okay. Now it should be equals to, ab can I write it like this? For e 5 log ex, so maine isko aise likh diya. That is e log ex to the power 5. Kyun? Because n log m is equals to log m to the power n minus, yahan par aa jayega aapke paas mein e, idhar par aayega log, yahan par aa jayega aapke paas mein e, yahan par aayega x, yahan par aa jayega 4 whole upon, again in the denominator e, yahan par aa jayega log e, yahan par aayega x cube minus, over here it's e, yahan par aa jayega log, and it's going to be e x square. Correct. Ab jab aap isko furthermore solve karoge, remember abhi tak maine isko integrate kiya hi nahi hai. This is, I am simply applying what? This is, I am simply applying the logarithmic series. So yahan par integration, not logarithmic series, it's a logarithmic properties. Please correct kar lena wahan par, it's not the exponential series, it's exponential properties. So e log e, e log e will be 1, 1 into x to the power 5 will be x to the power 5 minus e log e is 1, which is x to the power 4 whole upon e log e is 1, which is x cube minus e log e is again 1, which is x square dx. It should be equals to integration of, abhi tak integration chal raha hai, maine integration solve nahi kiya hai. So let's take out common from the numerator. So it's going to be x to the power 4 in bracket x minus 1 whole upon, denominator mein se x square common nikal deta hun. So it's going to be x minus 1 dx. Of course guys, this x minus 1 and x minus 1, because they are in multiplication with x4 and x square respectively, that's the reason why aap ise cancel kar doge. So kya bachega? It will x to the power 4 upon x square dx, or it should be equals to integration of x square dx cube. Ye square se square wale powers cancel ho jayenge. So ultimately aapka answer kya aayega? It should be equals to एक्स, अब मैंने इंटीग्रेशन सॉल्व किया है, सॉरी दैट इज 2 प्लस 1 अपॉन 2 प्लस 1 विच शुड बी इक्वल्स टू एक्स क्यूब अपॉन 3. सो दैट्स ऑल, इट्स डन. सो वी हैव रीच्ड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. लेट्स नाउ रब ऑल ऑफ दिस बोर्ड एंड लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. बट बिफोर मूविंग ऑन, लेट्स स्टार्ट राइटिंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 ओवर देयर. आई फॉरगेट इट, लेट्स राइट इट ओवर हियर. Now question number 7 says the questions are of trigonometric origin. So of course for trigonometric questions you require to learn basic formulas. For example, 1 minus cos 2x is equals to 2 sin square x. 1 plus cos 2x will give you 2 cos square x. So let's first of all move on to question number 6. 2 upon 1 plus cos 2x dx. Dx will always be with the numerator. It should be equals to 2 will remain as usual upon 1 plus cos 2x will remain what? 2 cos square x. Why? 1 plus cos 2 theta formula hota hai 2 cos square theta ka. So x tha, maine wo laga diya. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Dx abhi bhi hai. Integration of 1 upon cos square x will be sec square x dx. Please remember, jahan jahan par bhi cos square aayega, aapko usko sec square mein convert karna hota hai because cos square ka koi formula nahi hai hamare paas mein. Hamare paas cos x ka formula hai, cos square ka nahi hai. So integration of sec square x, abhi hum logo ne dekha tha, answer is tan x plus c. So that's all, it's done. Moving on to the next, that is 7th question. What is 7th? 2 upon, okay, this was 7th. Okay, my fault then. So it was 7th, sorry. So this will be now question number 8. So integration of 2 upon 1 minus cos 2x dx, it should be equals to integration of 2 upon 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sine square theta. So it's 2 sin square x. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So it will be integration of 1 upon sin square x will be cosec square x dx. What is cosec square x dx? Cosec x square x ka formula kya hota hai? That is minus cot x, jo aaj hi hum logo ne formula mein kiya tha. Minus cot x plus c. Kyunki cot x is minus cosec square x, right? Let's move on to 9th. Remember, these formulas, all of them have been done preceding this topic. Okay, aaj hi hum logo ne iske pehle kiya hua hai isko. Question number 9th. Cos 2x, integration of cos 2x plus 2 sin square x plus 2 sin square x whole upon cos square x dx. आपको मालूम होना चाहिए cos 2x के दो फॉर्मूलेज होते हैं. One is cos square x minus sin square x. Another is 1 minus 2 sin square x. And another is 2 cos square x minus 1. Now which one should I apply? Think about it. मैंने इंटीग्रेशन का साइन ऐसे ही रखा, cos 2x की जगह पर लिखा 1 minus 2 sin square x. But sir, why have you used this formula? Because minus 2 sin square x plus 2 se cancel ho jayega. Plus 2 sin square x whole upon cos square x. So if you can see this, minus 2 sin square x plus 2 sin square x dx will get cancelled. Aapko har bar exam mein tab tak dx lagana hai jab tak integration ka sign chal raha hoga. So then it is going to be integration of 1 upon cos square x dx, or it should be equals to sec square x dx, or it should be equals to tan x plus c. Of course, in the reason you need to write so that the invigilator would come to know aakhir ye aaya kahan se. So you need to write sec square x dx should be equals to tan x plus c. Aage badhte hain. Question number 10th. So question number 10th would go like this, that is 2 cos square x 2 cos square x minus cos 2x whole upon sin square x, and of course with the integration sign with the dx. Now how would you do this? Very simple. Again 2 cos square x, let it be like this, minus cos 2x. So in the place of minus cos 2x, let's apply a minus sign, let's apply a bracket. Cos 2x ke jagah par, this time I am using the formula 2 cos square x minus 1 whole upon sin square x. Now what do you think? Whenever the negative sign is going to, you know, get open in front of a bracket, the signs internally would be changing. So it would become what? It would become 2 cos square x minus 2 cos square x plus 1. So this will get cancelled whole upon sin square x dx. And this would become what? This would become 1 upon sin square x. And this would become cosec square x. Right? If you can see, till now I have not solved the integration. Now I have got the formula of cosec square x, which should be equals to minus cot x dx. And that's all it's done. Let's move ahead with the next, that is question number 11, 12 and 13. Or let it be like this. After running half of the part, now I am saying it will be like this. Okay, so question number 11. So how will I solve question number 11? In simple words, I can write it like this. 1 minus cos 2x, because this is integration. So 1 minus cos 2x will be 2 sin square x, formula hota hai, upon 2. 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square theta. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Sin square and root will get cancelled. So it will become what? That is integration of sin x dx, or it should be equals to minus cos x plus c. Formula. That's all. It's done. Let's write question number 12 now. 1 upon a to the power x, b to the power x. So can I write it like this? 1 upon a b to the power x. हाँ, because open करोगे तो same ही आएगा, right? So यहाँ पर dx डाल दिया, यहाँ पर भी मैंने dx नहीं डाला. Okay. Now, so इधर पर आ जाएगा आपके पास में, you are going to make it a b to the power minus x dx. What is integration of a to the power x? That was a to the power x upon log a. So answer is going to be a to the power x, that is a b to the power minus x upon log a, which is log is what? Log a b. But guys, there has to be a negative sign, because ye minus bhi tha, to minus yahan par aa jayega. जैसे वहां पर भी याद करो अपन माइनस साइन को आगे लेते थे, यहां पर भी आपने माइनस साइन को यहां ले लिया. सो दैट्स ऑल. एंड ऑफ कोर्स गाइस प्लस सी फॉर अ कांस्टेंट. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द लास्ट टर्म व्हिच इज 13th. ई टू द पावर लॉग रूट एक्स. नाउ प्लीज रिमेंबर गाइस, ई टू द पावर लॉग, इसका मतलब ही होता है दैट यहां पर रूट ई है. सो यू डोंट नीड टू आस्क सर, लेकिन आपने तो यहां पर लिखा ही नहीं है. In mathematics, it's always understood that e would always remain over there. So this is x. So this would become integration of e log e will be 1. So it will become root x upon x. It will become what? Root x ko maine root x hi likha. Of course, guys, dx. Again, I forgot. So root x upon, can I write x as root x into root x? Aap chaho to rationalize bhi kar sakte ho. So ultimately, this is going to become what? That is integration of 1 upon x to the power half dx, or it is going to become x to the power minus half dx, or this would become x to the power minus half plus 1 upon minus half plus 1 plus c. Our answer is x to the power half upon half, or this will become 2 root x plus c. And that's all is the answer to these questions. So guys, once again, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure that you do, by the way, you know, see the formulas first of all. If you do like the video, guys, of course, click on that sub button. And guys, press that finger, you know, up. If you feel like, if you don't feel like, guys, do whatever you feel like doing. Press the thumbs down, abuse, do whatever. Thank you guys so much. Bye. Enjoy.